the students. And I can remember the line many, many times that a C is a good grade. And now that I've had a few thousand medical students, they're not exactly going along with that line. So I put that out there. C is a very good grade. And but I am honored to be here today. And I remember when I came here to Washburn, I actually never really ever considered going anywhere else. I just said, I'm going to Washburn, even when I was a young boy. And I said, that's where I'm going to school. While other members of my family decided to go off to other schools, unmentionable schools. But, so I started out here as a major in mathematics and theater, which shows you exactly how well aligned my vision was and what I want to do. But after a year and a half of calculus, see, it's a good grade. I actually had set in on a biology, general biology class, and I looked at Dr. Tom O'Connor and I said, I want to do that. I want to be like him. I want to do that. So I went to Washburn, and I never left the university setting. So I'm still, you know, a university student in some way or another. I was inspired by the people that taught me. Each one of them have a unique story to tell about how meticulous, how caring they were, how they mentored the students, and how well they knew the students, and also sometimes the way they smiled at you when they knew that you really weren't getting away with what you thought you were getting away with. And I do think that when I came here, for example, I wanted to do a research project in biology, and so Dr. O'Connor set me up in some little closet, essentially, and and I had my own key, and so Dr. Farley, I don't know where the key is right now, but hopefully that's been forgiven, but it was just such a casual atmosphere. Dr. Cohen, the chairman of chemistry, we had access to machines, equipment that actually you couldn't touch those machines, mass spectrometers and things like that. And I remember Dr. Cohen, as we'd leave at the end of the day, looking at you like, close up and leave. And which was kind of interesting considering that my good friend Jim Rankin and I had this tendency towards skipping out of organic chemistry lab. I know other people claim that they never skipped anything, but we did come back later on and did our experiments. But we would go over to the swimming pool. At that time, it was in the basement of the field house, and it's a fairly small pool. And Jim Rankin and I would go swimming there, two or three times a week in the afternoon, just playing around like young guys are doing. And a woman comes into the pool with a couple of young sons. And the boys were maybe 5, 6 years old, they couldn't swim. So Jim and I decided, in addition to our other antics that we did in the pool, that we would teach them how to swim. And so we spent a number of weeks doing this rather than organic chemistry. It was a lot of fun. And the boys became quite good swimmers. And one afternoon we were standing in the shallow end of the pool with the boys swimming, and the mother had come in and let the boys in. She said, you know, their dad heard how well you did teaching them to swim. He wants to see, you know, how well they're swimming. I said, well, good. Jim and I were standing in the shallow end,
water is deep.
You know, it's just, you know, up to our hips. And the dad came in, Dr. Cohen. There is not enough water in that pool to hide what we really wanted to, you know, just standing there with that water right there, the boys were swimming along. Look at him, he knows where we're supposed to be. with the look, he's just going, Didn't the boys learn how to swim? He never said anything about it. Never said anything about it at all. But the boys didn't learn how to swim. But we did start going back to our game.